Good evening, Australia. Tonight, I want to talk to you about the global coronavirus.
The Lunar New Year holiday brings Chinese visitors in big numbers, and now a big risk of a new deadly virus arriving with them.
We are a little bit worried about it.
Coronavirus has claimed at least 9 lives in China, with more than 400 cases in 6 countries. The first in the US confirmed in Seattle, but as yet nothing in Australia.
The nation's chief medical officer concedes it is likely a case will make it to Australia, but insists our health services here are well prepared to respond and prevent it from becoming widespread.
The signs of infection include breathing problems, fever, shortness of breath and coughing.
We now have a confirmed case of the 2019 novel coronavirus in Victoria, the first case in Australia.
The last thing we want to do is be the epicentre of spread in this what's probably going to be a pandemic.
Authorities are now trying to work out where he's been and if anyone else was exposed.
Australia's coronavirus death toll climbed to 3 overnight.
Queensland's 11th case, 42 confirmed cases.
79 Australians have now tested positive.
Another 40 people on the ship now have the virus.
There is every reason for calm. There is every reason for people to go about their usual business.
This will take at least 6 months for us to get through, and it may be longer.
After infecting more than 40,000 people around the world, this virus finally has an official name, COVID-19. But progress on a safe, effective vaccine is much slower.
The global race continuing for a specific cure.
COVID-19 has now been confirmed in 80 countries, infecting 95,000 people around the world. California's declared a state of emergency. New York's famous subway is being disinfected. In Iran, 8% of the country's parliamentarians have tested positive.
Foreign nationals who have travelled in China within the last 14 days will be denied entry into the United States.
We're actually being evacuated right now.
For the first time ever, the Australian government telling Australians do not travel anywhere in the world.
Forcing anyone arriving in New Zealand into a 2-week quarantine.
No more incoming flights until the virus is contained.
Not only now is travelling overseas illegal, but many Australians who had a job just yesterday now do not.
One day you're working, the next day you're lining up for a handout. Doesn't sound good, but you know, that's the way it's got to be, unfortunately.
More businesses must close to stop the virus spreading.
New South Wales is warning that people who are refusing to self-isolate face tough penalties or even arrest.
If you're having friends over for dinner or friends over for drinks that are not members of your household, then you are breaking the law.
Enclosed spaces, including pubs, clubs, cinemas and entertainment venues will be closed from today.
From midnight tomorrow night, anyone entering Queensland will have to self-quarantine for 14 days.
South Australia, WA and the Northern Territory will close their borders from tomorrow.
Australians told to stay home whenever possible.
Doing what is called flattening the curve.
Funerals will be limited to just 10 people and weddings to 5.
And the worst is yet to come.
Panic buying. It's spreading faster than the disease that created it.
As for toilet paper supply, many supermarket shelves are still empty. The panic buying has even extended to tissues.
Woolworths is now making its own rules, setting a limit. 4 packets per customer per transaction.
Everyone grabs more than what they need.
The shelves are all empty, so I thought, grab it while it's there.
Just madness.
If you run out of toilet paper, the Red Cross will be able to assist you to get toilet paper. There is no need to be stockpiling toilet paper.
We're seeing runs on fruit and vegetables now. This is Coles in Collingwood.
Everyone's trolleys had 2 of everything, so everyone's doing it. So we're all perpetuating it.
They are the newest fashion accessory thanks to COVID-19. Surgical masks in such high demand, supplies are running out.
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you too.
I'm going to be showing you how to make this lovely height of fashion, the social distancing hat.
Xavier College will send Year 8 and 9 students home on Wednesday to trial a new online learning program.
Children don't seem to get either much in the way of infection, or if they do, they get very mild infections.
Sean, what's up, man? Good to see you. Ray, how are you?
Good morning, everybody. Good morning, everybody. Good morning, everybody. Good morning, everybody.
Several questions. Andrew, I'm sorry, but you don't run the press conference, okay?
Right, and then I see the disinfectant where it knocks it out in a minute.
I don't think there's anything wrong. We're not making it lawful to go for a run and eat a kebab.
Prime Minister Scott Morrison has revealed he's tested positive to COVID.
Prime Minister Boris Johnson is tonight in intensive care, suffering from the effects of coronavirus.
We don't have enough beds in intensive care.
This postponement is the first ever postponement of Olympic Games in Olympic history.
These are unprecedented times.
The coronavirus pandemic has radically changed the lives of almost every Australian.
1 million Australians have downloaded the government's COVID Safe Tracing app, an app the Prime Minister has said is crucial to stopping the spread of coronavirus. The vaccine rollout has officially begun. Across the nation, sleeves were rolled up, ready to get the jab Australia has been waiting for.
It will be time very soon that we'll be able to open those international borders again, and that will enable Australians who are fully vaccinated and Australians and residents of Australia who are overseas who are fully vaccinated to be able to travel again and to be able to lift those caps on our airports in states where they have moved into phase C of the program.
Over 2 years, so really great to be able to come home to Australia.
And now restrictions are being eased across parts of the country. We are slowly but surely starting to see the light at the end of the tunnel. It's safe to say that all of us have been affected in some way by this pandemic.